And now we will learn the last part about flipping houses, part 3, selling the property. What happens when you sell the property? Well, you no longer have the fixed asset in your records called Livingston Street. You no longer have the fixed asset in your records called renovations or upgrades. You do have more cash in the bank, and you have a gain or a loss on the sale. Those are the 4 things that are affected in your records when you sell the property. When you make the journal entry, simply list each of these things separately and everything will work out perfectly. It will be the easiest transaction you ever recorded. Before we do that, we have to add an account, or at least 2 accounts, into your chart of accounts. You have to add an account called gain on the sale of property, and that has to be an other income type of account. But just in case you might sell it as a loss, you should also add loss on the sale of property, and we will make that an other expense type of account. So, very simple, in the chart of accounts, list chart of accounts, again, in the bottom left, account, new. This one is other income, not income, other income, because it will go in a different place and it belongs in a different place in your profit and loss report. Click continue and we'll type in the words gain on sale of property. Then we'll click save a new and we'll choose other expense type of account and we'll put loss on sale of property and we'll put save and close. Now we have the 2 accounts we need just in case we have either a gain or a loss. For example, let's imagine on October 31 we sold the house for $150,000. Well, what do we do? If you look at the trial balance, we can see the amount we have here as debit for the building is $100,000. So in the journal entry, we have to make a credit to wipe that out, a credit for $100,000 to this account. Same thing with the renovations. It has a debit balance, but if we no longer have the building, we should not have this account in our chart of accounts. So because it's on the debit side, we have to make a credit to wipe it out. Now notice cash in bank now has a negative balance. And again, you can study about debits and credits in the supplemental videos, but if cash is credit, it means it's negative. That means when we get the $150,000, it will go on the debit side, and of course it will decrease it will not be a full $150,000 because we already have a little bit of a negative balance. And the difference will be either a gain or a loss. So, from the main menu, click Company, Make Journal Entry. Click OK, and of course we have to put the date, October 31st of 2020. Now, again, this building has a debit balance, so we have to make a credit of $100,000 for the building, for that particular account, building on Livingston Street. Then when we click the next line, QuickBooks is trying to balance the entry for us. It doesn't know that we're not finished after 2 accounts. So let's wipe out what QuickBooks suggests. Go ahead and find the renovation account, renovations 110 Livingston Street, and that was a debit balance of $15,000. So to wipe it out, because we sold the house, we have to make a credit. Push tab. Now, the cash we got goes into cash in bank, but it's not $115,000. Remember, QuickBooks is just trying to balance the entry. Change it to the actual amount of cash that we got. Push tab. Now, if we keep pushing tab, QuickBooks again is trying to balance the entry, and it's showing us that the difference between all that we paid for the house and the amount we got paid for the house, That difference is $35,000. And because the amount we got paid was more than what we paid for the house plus what we renovated, we now have to choose this account, gain on sale of property. So, did we account for all four of these items in the journal entry? Yes, we did. Compare each of the things that were necessary to what we actually put. Now, when we click Save and Close and click OK, aha, you can see the building is gone, it's down to zero. The renovations are gone, it's down to zero. Cash went from a $2,000 or $3,000 negative balance to $147,000 positive balance because we received $150,000. And of course, at the bottom here, you see gain on the sale of property. Now, I need to show you what the normal profit and loss would look like with this gain. From the main menu, click Reports, Company and Financial, Profit and Loss Standard, and push A for All. Notice the profit and loss has a normal income section. See, here's an income section, income from late fees, rental income earned, and the total income. Then it has an expense section for all of the different expenses that we paid during the course. And then it has ordinary income. So we made normal rental income minus expenses this amount, $56,675. However, in an additional section for something that we don't normally do on a regular basis, we had another income that's listed here at the bottom, gain on sale of property, and now this net income is the real amount of net income that should be considered when filing for your taxes. Now, to get the whole picture, you should try a second example. Let's imagine that we instead sold the house for $95,000. Well, let's just delete what we entered. If we click the journal and scroll to the bottom, we get the most recently entered transactions. We can double-click this, then click Edit Transaction in order to bring it back in front of you. Then you can delete it. Click Delete and click OK. Now, we'll re-enter it fresh. Let's imagine that we sold the house. So again, building on Livingston Street, we have to make a credit for $100,000. The renovations account, same thing. It has a debit balance of $15,000, so we have to make a credit of that same amount to wipe it out. But now this time the cash in bank that we got was only $95,000. So when QuickBooks balances the entry, aha, QuickBooks says we need a debit this time to balance the entry. We need a debit this time because the amount of cash on the debit side that we received is not as much as the total that we paid for the house and the renovations. So if the cash we got is not the same as, is not more than the total of the, what we paid for the house and the renovations, then that difference logically is a loss on the sale of property. And this is what it would look like if you got less than what you paid for the house plus what you paid to renovate. You would have this loss. When we click Save and Close and click OK, we can notice that the profit and loss now shows a loss on sale of property for $20,000, and it lowered our ordinary income.